You know, last episode, Mr. Kevin, I tried to trick him, but I'm not very good at tricking people. I don't like to make people uncomfortable for very long. So I was like, you're missing something. I'm like, never mind. I'm just kidding. And it didn't work.
We saw through your trickery, Mrs. Molly.
Yeah, I'm not good at it. It's just not in my nature.
That's probably a good thing.
It is a good thing. Well, friends, let's check in with our zones, shall we?
Yeah, we can do that. A zone check-in coming right up.
Mr. Kevin?
Yes.
How are you feeling today?
Well, let me do this and then this. There we go. I'm the blue physically and I'm the green mentally.
I feel ya.
How about that?
And it's interesting. We keep talking about how we can be in different zones depending on if we're focusing on our physical or our emotions or our brain. It's all.
And sometimes one of those things can kind of overtake all the other ones. Yeah. What about you, Miss Oslin?
I'm good to go. I'm in the green zone. I feel calm. I'm happy. I mean, I'm calm, but I'm happy. I'm good to go.
Yeah, I'm pretty much. I've got a little blue, but I'm mostly in the green zone.
Awesome.
So we're good to go.
All right. Hey, right. Let's remind ourselves of our three personal standards.
Oh, yes.
Today and every day when we come together, we agree to
show respect, make good decisions, solve problems. And you know by now how we are going to start by showing respect. We are going to honor our Indigenous lands and peoples by recognizing them and recognizing the people who came before us.
Yes. So we are going to invite you to look out your window, look at the sky and the trees in your surroundings. Our physical space stands on the unceded land of the Coast Salish people. We acknowledge the Coast Salish community, their elders, both past and present, as well as future generations. And we make this acknowledgement as part of our work to dismantle the ongoing legacies of settler colonialism and white supremacy. Mm-hmm. So we're acknowledging that we are on land that is not ours.
Thank you.
Yep. And we'll continue to do that. And we're going to continue to learn more
about that
and how it applies to our Washington State history.
And how that happened.
And how it happened. Mm-hmm. Now,
so our essential question.
Mm-hmm. Last time we looked at Washington State, the map, and we learned a lot about the five regions and the land features in each region.
We did.
And during this unit, we're going to continue to learn about how the land features and regions in Washington State have shaped and changed our state history. And today, we're going to look specifically at one region and the land features and how that impacts the industry and resources in that area. So we started last time by looking at this observation chart, and we noted that these pictures are all in Washington State, and they all looked really different. And I wonder, now that we know more about the regions,
if we could figure out where they would go on that map. I was wondering the same thing. Do you have any ideas, friends, where these might go?
Thinking of the five regions.
The coast, the Western Lowlands, the Cascade Range, the Okanagan Highlands, and the Columbia Plateau. Where might these be?
I know the top two, but the bottom one I'm having a hard time thinking about.
It could kind of go in a couple different places.
What are you thinking?
Well, the coast is that beautiful picture of the beach. That's for sure.
Yep.
The bottom one, I think, is kind of in that spot between the Cascade Range and the Okanagan Highlands and the Columbia Plateau. And I'm wondering if all of that flat land, that's kind of after you get over the mountains, if that whole thing is the Columbia Plateau, or if it's just part of it.
Yeah.
So I'm going to do some more research, because I have a wondering, and I don't know.
That's where I was getting confused as well, and wondering about that. And then Mount Rainier is obviously
part of the Cascade Range. So that's something that you need to understand, too, is that, like, teachers don't know everything. We're learning along with you as well. And so that's the great part about learning and teaching, is that we get to learn together. So if you're wondering the same thing, I would highly recommend that you do some research. And if you find out something interesting, send us an email.
Maybe it's something that you think you already know.
Or maybe I put them wrong.
Ooh.
And that would be okay too. And I'll go back and fix it.
That's always neat when students correct the teacher.
Oh, I love it. Because then when we know better, we do better, right? Right. I always encourage my students to be paying close enough attention that they can catch my mistakes.
Yep.
And I'm very grateful when they do.
Yep. Feedback is a gift.
It sure is.
All right. We did some thinking last time about what we think we know about Washington history and what we want to know about Washington history.
So I have one to
I noticed
add.
Mrs. Wally is making a good decision and she's getting her T-chart out that she created and she's already getting in and revising it. She's adding more to what she wants to know.
I want to put that down before I forget it.
Yeah.
I want to know what region,
R-E-G-I-O-N.
I want to know what region the space between the Cascades and the Highlands and Plateau is called. And I just did some shorthand note there. I don't know if you could see it, but I was running out of space, but I need to know what's on here. So I put Highland HMP for Highlands and Plateau. This is my thinking. This is my brain dump and thinking. So as long as I know what it says, that's what matters. This is for me.
Exactly.
And so as long as you know what yours says, that's what matters.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's review our words that we learned last time.
Oh, yes. These are good.
These are important to our essential question.
And important to understanding our state.
We learned that the word plateau is a high-level area of land.
And it's flat, and it's typically flat. On the top.
We learned that a region is an area with common climate and certain features. And we learned that lowland is land that is low in respect to the surrounding country. Oh, and look at that. I have a sentence using lowlands this time. I think it was just cut off.
Oh, look at that.
Dairying is a leading industry in rural Washington lowlands.
There it is. Very good. Wonderful. Now, here's something I'm thinking about in regards to my wonder.
Yes.
A region is an area with common climate and certain features. The other side of the Cascades does not have the same climate or the same features as the Cascade Range does. So I am very curious to figure out what part that is. I'm going to look it up. I'm
excited. We're going to do some research.
Next episode, I'll let you know.
Okay. Let's do some more words because we're going to need those for our learning today.
You're going to need them for today.
Ooh, industry.
Industries.
What do you think that might mean? Where have you heard it? Or have you never heard it?
Industries. I've heard industrious, which means like strong and capable and works hard.
Yes. I was thinking that industry might mean work. Having something to do with work.
What do you think at home? What do you think industry means? Let's find out what it means, shall we?
Turning raw materials into finished product.
So industries must use the things we already have here in Washington. And turn them into finished products.
So if we think about like the fishing industry.
What about the shipping industry?
Shipping industry.
They're not. They're taking product from one place to another, but they're using the raw product of the water.
They are. My sentence that I came up with was: Washington has a strong dairy industry.
We do.
We take raw material
and turn it into finished product.
Milk and ice cream.
Smith Brothers Farms is one that's local.
Yes.
Yummy.
Okay. Resources.
Things you use. Like when I have to gather resources for a project, resources are the things I'm going to use to finish it.
I was thinking very similar. Stuff I have. Those are my resources that I can use. Resources are an area's wealth and means of producing wealth. So things that they have that they can use.
To produce
wealth. Salmon, timber, and hydropower are resources in Washington. Salmon, timber, and resources are Washington's means of producing wealth.
I wonder if different states have different resources.
Ooh, based on their landforms or where they are. their history.
Hang on.
Add it to the chart.
I'm going to add it to my chart. I'm going to have to go to the back here, make a new one. I'm just going to make the T-chart with a exclamation point, I think I know, and a question mark. Do all states have the same resources as Washington? Mm-hmm. Good question. Okay.
Okay, one more word.
As we're working, that's what we want you to be doing. If a question pops up in your head, jot it down in your you want to know.
Mm-hmm. Economy. Ooh. I hear this word a lot on the news.
Yep, economy. Well, if we're talking about work and the things they have to produce wealth, it must mean the money.
That's what I was thinking. Mm-hmm. Economy is the system of how money is made and used. Mm. Not like printing the money, but earning money.
Like how does the trade happen?
Yes.
Where back before there was money, they would trade the things, the resources they had mm-hmm. for other people's resources. And now we trade the resources that we create for their money.
Mm-hmm. And then, so that's how we make the money. And then also we have to think about how we use that money. That's also part of our economy. Mm-hmm. Oh, there it is. Washington has many resources which create a thriving economy.
Oh, I'm glad we could see it at the bottom.
I know, right?
We do have many resources. I'm excited to show you some of them, just the ones in the Western Lowlands.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's do our Washingtonian
Boogaloo. Oh, yes, this
was
a good one.
By Jean Marie Wright.
Here we go, friends.
Do it with us.
Okay, that's why we give you the words.
Uh-huh. I'm a Washingtonian, and I'm here to say, I walk in the rain almost every day. Sometimes I walk the mountains or along the ocean waves.
Enjoying nature in every way.
Rainforest, mountains, rivers too. Doing the Washingtonian boogaloo. Washington has five regions, so I'm told. And some of them so rich they even have gold. There are coastlines and mountains and plateaus so big. We can all choose just where we want to live. Rainforest, mountains, rivers too. Doing the Washingtonian boogaloo.
There are Native Americans who live across this land and help to make this state so grand.
Salish, Yakima, and Palouse tribes too. All of them part of our history so true. Rainforest, mountains, rivers too. Doing the Washingtonian boogaloo.
That was fun.
That was really fun.
So, I heard a lot of, let's see.
Mm-hmm.
The five regions, some of them so rich, they even have gold. I wonder what else we have in our Western Lowlands. Today, we...
Oh, yes, Mr. Kevin.
Yes, I just wanted to tell you that I was, while you were doing the boogaloo, I was back here looking up how big is the Columbia Plateau and where is it exactly?
Yeah.
I pulled up a picture.
Can we see?
So that it's huge. The Columbia Plateau is not just in Washington State.
Look at that.
It goes down into Oregon and Idaho.
And it butts up against the Cascade Range.
Yeah.
And I wonder if the Okanagan Highlands are that other part to the Cascade Range. I bet it is.
Yeah.
So interesting.
Isn't that neat?
That's amazing. I know the Okanagan Highlands go up into Canada.
What is the key telling us that the colors are?
Let's see. So the yellow is major Quaternary volcanoes.
Oh,
those are, those
I'm
are
sorry,
the red
that's
triangles.
The little red cones. Those are all the volcanoes. Columbia River Basalt Group is the green.
Oh.
And there's some other words I can't pronounce here.
So interesting.
Yeah, that's great. Thanks, Mr. Kevin.
Mm-hmm.
So in our last lesson, we learned about all the different regions. Today, we're going to focus on the Western Lowlands and the industries and resources within the Western Lowlands region. This is where we live.
It is where we live.
Mm-hmm. And we have... off the
Hang
coast.
On, we're going to let Mr. Kevin zoom out just a second so we can see the coast.
Get rid of this. I guess that doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter. It's fine.
So off our west coast, we have the Pacific Ocean.
Woohoo!
So we're going to think about
right here.
The water industries
Ooh,
what comes from the
industries.
Water?
Well,
what do we use the water?
I'm going to let you just read some of those off, and I'm going to draw pictures while
shipping?
You do it. Ooh, look at this.
You mentioned that one.
Yeah, look at this boat. I've got a boat here.
That's a big one that we talk a lot about in my house, because Mr. Oslin works for the Port of Tacoma, mm-hmm. where a lot of ships
now,
come into.
This is a ship that's doing something a little bit different Ooh. Than the shipping industry. Now, here's the shipping industry. Remember I was talking about that Strait of Juan de Fuca?
Yes.
And how important it is. That Strait of Juan de Fuca comes into the Western Lowlands. And what it does is it allows ships to come from places like Russia and China and bring goods that we are trading with other countries.
So resources that we don't have mm-hmm. here.
And we import them. And then we trade and the ships go back out with our resources to their places.
So shipping is one water industry. Fishing is another, which I think is that what that mm-hmm. other?
Yeah, we fish for things like salmon, oysters, trout. Here's my little oyster picture. We have a crabbing industry off mm-hmm. our coast.
Where we take the raw goods of the crab and sell them for
yeah,
people
all
to
in
eat.
The Puget Sound area, we have crabs and oysters and fish. We also have mussels mm-hmm. and clams.
Mm-hmm. And then the water resources.
Ooh. We have the Pacific Ocean.
Mm-hmm. There's lots of lakes.
We
and
have lakes within the Western Lowlands, like Lake Washington.
Mm-hmm. Lake Chelan.
Yep. We have rivers and estuaries that flow.
Oh, Lake Chelan is not in the Western Lowlands.
It's not,
that's
though.
Why.
Yep.
Okay.
And that's the estuaries. This mm-hmm. is these are like the estuaries. That's like where the salt water is mixing in with the fresh water going into the rivers.
We learned about salmon and
yes.
where the salt water and the fresh water.
So think about how important those estuaries are for the Salish Sea and the habitat and health of our salmon. Super important. And then Puget Sound, and that's where we have the ships come in. We have a port here in Tacoma, and we also have a port in Seattle. And the big, huge ships come in, and they offload all those containers and then unload new containers.
That's what all those big cranes, if you mm-hmm. are able to see out into the Port of Tacoma, those mm-hmm. big cranes are helping offload from those ships.
Now, something about the lakes is we do some fishing in the lakes, mm-hmm. but it's not much of an industry from the lake. Most of the fishing industry comes from the saltwater in the coast.
Mm-hmm. But we do have recreation.
We do. And in the land area, we have lakes. And on those lakes, what do they do, Miss Oslin?
Well, I've been skiing on a lake before.
Ah,
boating,
sailing.
See lots of sailboats out on mm-hmm. like Commencement Bay.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, one thing that a lot of friends of mine like to do out at Hammersley Inlet, but I'm not brave enough, is paddleboarding.
Yep, that's where you stand on here with a paddle. You paddle
takes
away.
Takes core strength.
It does.
And balance. There's also
windsurfing at Lake Wenatchee. Mm-hmm. That's not, I've seen people do it on Lake Washington. Mm-hmm. That's one of the main spots for windsurfing, and it's fun.
Yeah.
And kite surfing. So they like attach themselves with a harness to a kite, and they're on a surfboard, mm-hmm. and they let the wind take them on the kite, and they go speedy across the lake. It's so fun to watch.
That is fun to watch. I wouldn't want to do it.
What a fun place to live.
Yeah. Now, with all of these industries and resources, Ooh. Things that support our local economy, there are negative impacts on water that we have to talk about
there
and acknowledge.
There are.
So with all of these ships coming in and out,
we have problems like water pollution. Think about all the oil mm-hmm. and things that come out of the ships. We have oil spills. Lots of ocean traffic. We Ooh. Went to the Foss mm-hmm. Waterway seaport. We saw that whale mm-hmm. that got hit by a big container ship.
Yes.
Because the container ship didn't know it was there and the whale didn't know the container ship was there. And it killed a really important part of our ecosystem.
Mm-hmm. That's a problem.
Mm-hmm. Over harvesting.
That's
we tend as humans to be kind of greedy.
Mm-hmm. Especially when it comes to money, right?
Right, because money is how we have wealth and trade and get the things we need. So if there's a lot of it, we want to take it all. But we're learning that that has really big negative impacts on our system. Mm-hmm. So we want to take a little bit and leave a lot mm-hmm. for nature to do what nature does. Mm-hmm. The negative impacts are shipping. Those shipping, as much as we need those industries, mm-hmm. those shipping ships can really pollute things and
mess with the
life of mm-hmm. the Salish Sea. And then we import and export internationally, which is good, but it's those ships again.
The traveling,
yeah. And it disrupts the marine life.
It does. Mm-hmm. Okay, should we talk more about the mountain ranges?
Yeah, let's do the mountains. Go ahead and stick these up here. So we have lots of different mountains. Well, the big mountain range we learned last time is called the Cascades. We also have the Okanagan Range. Mm-hmm. That's kind of up in the northeast corner, and that kind of starts where the Rockies are. And that goes down into the Midwest of the United States. Because we've got these mountains. What happens here on these mountains?
Well, I never even thought about how land can also be a resource.
Thinking about how these resources have, while they're resources, mm-hmm. when we take them and use them, they can have negative impacts. Mm-hmm. We've got to keep that in mind.
Mm-hmm. So we have mountains and foothills.
Mm-hmm.
Trees. Trees are a huge resource here in Washington State.
So many friends. When I've had family visit, I have family from Australia. My mom grew up in Australia. They come to visit, and the thing they just can't get over is all the green trees. Mm-hmm. That there are just so many green trees. Mm-hmm.
Then there's also valleys and harbors.
Yeah.
So harbors are out on the coast. Let's talk about the timber.
Ooh, yeah.
Did you know, I didn't know this, timber covers half of our state in Washington? Timber is trees.
Like I said, we have a lot of trees.
So what that means is that we also have industries that use the timber.
Mm-hmm.
For example, Weyerhaeuser.
Yes. And they do that to make paper. And you know what we have in Tacoma?
The aroma
of Tacoma. Do you know what that is? That's a paper pulp mill.
Mm-hmm.
And they're making paper pulp for things like paper and tissues mm-hmm. and paper towels. They take the wood, they grind it all up,
mm-hmm.
and they make paper.
They also use the timber to make lumber, Ooh. Which is important for
things like building houses.
Yes.
Right? Oh.
So there's 21 million acres of timber.
Now, I want us to think for a minute, fourth graders. Whose habitat is all this timber? We've got some elk and deer and bears and all sorts of and salmon mm-hmm. who are in streams and need the shade of the trees to protect the streams they're spawning in and protect their eggs.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of timber, 21 million acres of timber.
I can't even understand what that means.
That's a lot of timber.
There is.
Ooh, we have some mountains down here too. Now, there are some fun things about the land resources and these mountains.
Yes. There's Crystal
What's
Mountain.
What's fun?
Mm-hmm. Crystal Mountain Ski Resort.
There's a couple different ski resorts that we have, but we're going to talk about Crystal Mountain. What can you do there?
Skiing.
You can go skiing. I'm going to draw a pair of skis.
And when you go skiing, if you go skiing or snowboarding, you pay to use that resource. So that's how it's part of our economy. Mm-hmm.
You can go snowboarding mm-hmm. with their little snowboarding boots.
Something that I like to do is go biking, like mountain biking.
You can go mountain biking. I'm going to draw my little bike.
So when you go to parks in Washington State, you often have to have a discovery pass, and you pay money for that.
You can go hiking. It's so fun to go hiking and like use a little hiking pole, right? You have your little backpack and go see all these beautiful views.
Mm-hmm.
But there's a really important rule. What you pack in, you must pack out. Do not leave anything behind.
Mm-hmm. Take it with you.
I'm going to say that again in my teacher voice.
Again. Yeah.
Do not leave anything behind. do not take anything that you did not bring in.
Ooh, say that one again.
Do not take anything that you did not bring in. It doesn't belong to you. It belongs to the animals in the habitat.
Leave nature in nature.
Take a picture of it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And camping.
Oh, I love to go camping.
You know, Mr. Wally, when he climbed Mount Rainier, he got to go camping. They saw lots of bears.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
There's also Gifford Pinchot. I don't know how to say that.
Pinchot?
My mic was off. Gifford Pinchot.
Gifford Pinchot, right. National Forest, where you can also go hiking and camping. Okay, well, if we're talking about resources,
we use them. And if we use them, then they're gone. So we have to think about that and be really wise about what we're using, because if we use it all up, mm-hmm. we're not going to have it.
So if we cut all the trees down, that's called clear cutting.
And it looks like this. Does that look like a place that elk and deer and things want to live?
Nope.
There's no green left. It's just a bunch of wood stumps.
Mm-hmm. So that's the destruction of habitats for mm-hmm. our animals. Also, those trees, when they have roots and they help hold the ground where it's supposed to be. And if we don't have trees, then we have erosion.
And landslides.
Landslides. Also, river and water pollution.
Yep.
Oh, like you mentioned going camping. Garbage. People just leaving their garbage.
So it's a huge problem, friends. That's why I said it. People don't think. They're like, oh, I brought it in. Oh, my one little piece of wrapper that went flying away isn't a big deal. But if 5,000 people do that, we now have 5,000 pieces of wrappers, and that's a really big deal.
And even if we remember to pack it out, it still has to go to a landfill.
So you have to be really aware of what you're doing and how that impacts our land. So while industry and resource is really great, it's not a bad thing because it helps us live and thrive. It's shaped our, mm-hmm. our whole state. Mm-hmm. We have to be critical consumers of that.
Mm-hmm. And then the last thing that really has been hit us really bad in the last several years is wildfires or forest fires.
Part of that's due to the climate change. And there being a lot hotter summers mm-hmm. and not as wet winters and not as much snow. Luckily, this year, basically, that's what it looks like. It's just everything's on fire.
Mm-hmm.
This year, our snowpack's been really great. And so they're really hopeful that everything up top that normally burns really quickly is going to be really nourished and green and wet. And so we aren't going to have as bad of a problem this year, they're hoping.
Hopefully. This is also where it has to do with, like, pack out what you pack in. So cigarette butts or things like your fire, if you're camping, you have to put it out and don't light a fire.
And make sure that you're listening to all of the restrictions because typically in middle of July, they'll say no more campfires.
Burn ban.
Because it's so, so dry that one ember can light a forest fire.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to protect that resource and make sure that if you do have a fire, that it's put all the way out before mm-hmm. you leave.
And this is also, just thinking about all of our industries and resources mm-hmm. here in the Western Lowlands, how we can really partner with our Indigenous populations
yes.
and think about what they have done historically to protect the land
yep.
so that we're not just coming in
and ruining this beautiful place. Mm-hmm. Be really aware of the land you're using and that you're using it in a way that's respectful.
Mm-hmm. So today we did some thinking about mm-hmm. how the land features of regions, specifically the Western Lowland region in Washington State, change and shape our history.
So let's think about that for a second.
Hmm.
How did the land shape the industry we have here in Washington State? When people first arrived, like I don't see on here, like I know farming is part of it, but mm-hmm. I don't think it's a big part of it.
Not here in the Western Lowlands.
No.
Mm-mm.
But over on the east side, it is. Huge part of it.
Yeah. Because they have the land features that support that.
I think this is a really big part.
I think so.
Because it's access for lots of the whole entire country. Mm-hmm. To have those shipping containers and be coming into that coastal area.
I wonder if we should modify our essential question. It says land features. Maybe we should add water. Land and water
I
features.
I think we should. So we have the Puget Sound, right? Mm-hmm. The Salish Sea. That has shaped our industry. That's how we get fishing and clamming and crabbing. Mm-hmm.
Even our rivers, too.
Our rivers,
right?
Yeah. And then, oh, the timber.
The timber.
So much timber.
And the timber is in the mountains.
Right. So we have to go get it features. And bring them down.
Mm-hmm. And also the recreation. Mm-hmm. That's part of our economy and using
right. And the lowlands have hills, mm-hmm. right? They don't have the really big ones, mm-hmm. but they do have hills that then look onto the bigger mountains. So interesting.
Very. So, fourth graders, today your job is to do some thinking about how do the land features of Washington State determine resources and industries that are available to us?
Yeah, think about what we can use to help boost the economy of Washington State. In a responsible way. It's okay to use it. You need to use it responsibly.
Yes. So that's going to be your assignment today is to mm-hmm. think about the relationship between the land features and water features mm-hmm. of Western Lowland, Washington, here in Tacoma or Puget Sound, and post something on Flipgrid if you're comfortable.
Yeah. What did you learn? What resources can we use to have industry in Washington State?
Mm-hmm. Now, if Flipgrid not isn't your thing. Jinx. There are two other ways that you could send us your thinking. Mr. Kevin.
Fourth graders, you can send us an email to tvclassroom@tacoma.k12.wa.us. You can always give us a shout mm-hmm. on a little piece of whatever, a card or a piece of paper. I'm just kind of riffing around here. You could put that in an envelope, stick a stamp on it, you know, and send it to us. Mm-hmm. TV Classroom, 601 South 8th Street, Tacoma, Washington, 98405.
Awesome.
Now, our affirmation today, as you were talking about the negative impacts and of the industries and resources that we have mm-hmm. in the Western Lowlands of Washington, and you use the word critical consumer, mm-hmm. thinking about your garbage, but we can also think about what other resources, natural or otherwise, mm-hmm. that we consume and try to make responsible choices about what we purchase, where we purchase it from.
How we use it, how we dispose of it if we're done.
So we need to remind ourselves that I am a critical consumer.
Mm-hmm.
We need to be thinking about what we're doing and analyzing it and making sure that it's what's best for everyone and everything.
It's part of being a member of a community mm-hmm. is analyzing and being a critical thinker. Mm-hmm. We don't just want to go through life not thinking about how we impact others. Mm-hmm. It's so important to be critical of what we do so that when we know better, we do better.
Exactly.
Okay.
Okay. Let's all take our deep breath together and say our affirmation.
I am a critical consumer.
Excellent job today, fourth graders. We can't wait to see what you send us about your learning. Mm-hmm. And we look forward to seeing you back here next time in our TV classroom.
Bye, friends. I'll see you on Flipgrid.
Rules 1. You have 10 seconds to pick your crewmate. 2. A new timer will appear with an exercise for the crewmate you picked. 3. You will get 10 points for each correct crewmate and exercise you choose. 4. If you pick the imposter, you will lose all your points. 5. See how many points you can get. Good luck!